So I recently created a new lower third template for Premiere Pro. What's unique about this lower third is that it automatically expands to the new length of text. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to use it. And if you want to download it, you can become a patron on my Patreon page, where you can download this as well as several other assets and templates for Premiere Pro and After Effects. So without further ado, let's dive into today's video. So I'm inside Premiere Pro, and to get started, I'm going to go up to my workspaces and change it to captions and graphics. Then where you want to go is in the bottom right corner, click the button, then go and navigate your Moger and click open. This will add it to your essential graphics panel. Click and drag it to your timeline. I'm going to expand the screen here, that way we can see it. And when we play this back, you can see we have a nice lower third template. Now to edit it, just click on the lower third, and there's three different categories. Under master controls, you have the position controls for the entire lower third, so you can change the X and Y, as well as a scale, so you can make it larger or smaller, and then rotation. So these controls operate and control the whole lower third together, but then there are separate controls where you can edit the individual lines. So for example, we have the name bar controls, so we can type in our new text, and as you can see, it will auto resize. So, you know, we can change the casing, the font, and the lower third will automatically change to the correct size of the new text. We have other options as well, such as changing the color. So I'm just going to stylize this a little bit, maybe change the font to maybe a gold yellowish, and then maybe change it the background to a purple. And then underneath, you'll notice that there's a skew option. By default, it's set to skew, but you can make that zero and you'll just get a rectangle box. You'll also notice that there's a roundness section, so you can just twirl that all the way up and you get a nice rounded rectangle. Now you'll notice under here that you have the stroke option, so you can expand the width of the stroke as well as the color. So I'm just going to match it to that gold yellow color as well and maybe knock down the stroke size a little bit. And then underneath that, you'll notice that there is this offset path amount. This will basically expand the lower third a little bit more around the text. Then you have other options below. You can change the position. So if it's just a little bit off, you can adjust just the name bar specifically for the position, as well as the rotation and the opacity as well. So those are the controls inside the name bar for this lower third. Now under title bar controls, you can change the title of the person. So you can update that text and same thing, it auto sizes. You can change the font as well. And then just to illustrate, if you change the size of the font, you can see that the bar changes size with the text. So it is very reactive. I'm gonna change the colors just to match, maybe do the invert. So yellow, gold background and purple text. And same things here, you can change the skew and you can make it more round. I'm gonna change the stroke color to that purple. And I'm going to change the stroke a little bit, make it a little thicker, as well as add some padding, some offset path amount, a little higher so we have a little bit more space. I'm just going to slide this over and move the position around. All right, so now that we have that, as a whole, the lower third needs to be a little bit bigger. So if we go back up to our master controls, we can change the size. So we can just scale it up and move it over using the position and scale properties. And now when we play this back, you can see we have an updated new custom stylized lower third using this Moger template. Now, one cool thing about this lower third is that you can really resize it to be any length of time without compromising the animation. As you can see, you can make it like 2 minutes long if you want, and it still animates out normally. Or on the flip side, you can also make this very short. So say if you only need it at 4 seconds long, you can easily just click and drag the side of it and make it around 4 seconds long. So really, it can be as fast or long as you need it to be for your own video project. So that's the new lower third template that I created for Premiere Pro. If you want to see other videos, there's several on my channel, a lot of Premiere Pro tutorials. Here's one that you might like right up there. But otherwise, thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.